I guess I'll talk about the removing perceptions. When we're dealing with perceptions of the self that are over-communicated as overdone, like you envision yourself as the expressant overdue. When I say the expressant overdue, like an anxietal vision, reback, an anxietal vision. And this anxietal vision reback is like it's not actually you. It's more as a fear vision of how others have construed you and how they have put you in place. They have put you in a place. How they have. And yet it is from obvious visions of one's own self, this particular view. It's obvious visions of your own self, but yet they realm higher into an extreme drama state, and they realm higher into a state that is not really your true you. It is more an exclamant person, meaning an exclamatory. We can take this oddly, I'll call them the reback visions that are harvesting in a way into your own mind that are incorrect. Almost trying to express that this is her, this is him, this is this person. In extremes, in the extremic, when there is a tantalizing scorecard on the extreme, we must see this woman in the crazy self. We must see this man in the most decadent dark, and we must see this other in the most overdone technical. The most overdone technical. So where are these affirmments coming from that are creating these reback visions? These affirmments are coming from what? The persons that you have ever encountered, the persons you have ever talked to, the persons who are writing descriptors in their own head of you. Is that where it's coming from? Seems as we are here on this internet, we are receiving perception directly through perception of others also, intake from these this particular medium source. So is it the generalizations? Is it the generalizations? In general, she was the fatal. You know, so you see yourself as inexpressed the fat. Or it has been written, or is it been written out there, perhaps? Somebody is writing certain things specifically on person. And so there is a build accumulate. That is causing an aggressive revision into the mind, the visions in your mind. Like looking at, I will say it is like looking at the cards as, you know, you're going through the cards, any card, the tarot or whatever, but yeah, it is a tarot of yourself essentially, but it's the wrong one. It is not, that is not me, that is not me, that is wrong, I am not this particular. It is almost as pieces of you, of your person, have been misunderstood. So it is the misunderstood vision that is being thrown back into the headspace. The misunderstood vision. negative future I'm seeing. Oh my gosh, it sounds like I'm gonna be losing lots of weight. Getting this negative. Oh my gosh. Yeah, so we have to actually keep the this is terrible, huh? All of the parallels, and you're going, oh, is this the quantum, everything paralleling this way and that way? They did say a long time ago the quantum computer was to be invented around this 2010, 2011 time. Anyway, so I am wondering, it's I didn't hear it on the radio. I wasn't listening. I guess I get it the other way. Because I didn't have to hear it on the radio, get it to launch. And what it is the expression of many things, blown from one phrase. You can even take you can take one phrase, and then it just bounces off into another phrase, and then down into another, and into another, and into another, but yet all off the same set of words, or the same one word. It can just be one word, and it will just flash tune itself into many different variations of it. So it is kind of like a computer junkie self that just keeps going and going. Give me this version of it, and give me that version of it. At first it seems like, oh, this is a wonderful entertainment to my intelligence. But yet, on the other hand, it just starts to become a time consumption. You always have to pick the best one. You have to pick the best one, the most favorite definition of it. And sometimes stop it, because it becomes like, oh my gosh, would you just stop going. Stop flowing into another tangent of it, of the words themselves and their meanings. It's as if to be living in all of the dictionaries and all of the mathematic books and numerologies all at once, unfolding. And then all the stigmas and the ridiculous songs from the past, songs that, and lyrics, all of them all smushed together, everything is just pluck and play, I guess, though, they call it. Well, anyway, that's my particular thought of what quantum is. It's just simply a whole bunch of different versions of remember those times. It was the just like this here, it says peaches. I made this on one point there. It says peaches, and so on the immediacy of peaches, there is in your own mind, you could say peach tree, or you could say somebody who called you that once, or you know, you go straight to the song peaches, or you go to other thoughts. So that's what this quantamic state is all about. It just seems to just be again and again and again, and then I'm like, well, no, I don't really want to talk about peaches at all, but yet it can take you there in such a way that it becomes ridiculous. It becomes a time swallower. And now somebody out here on the internet will be like, I was just going to buy the peaches today, the special. And so we have a thing together. And no, it's not meaning anything. I have nothing together with you because you're thinking about the peaches. for some reason there is this man or woman show, we will have to find this attachment self. We have to find this oh, something in common. Or it could be woman to woman or man to man, but yeah, they have to have something in common. All of a sudden, showing up, you know. Oh, don't ruin my day. Don't ruin my day. You know, need something in common. Just like this other day, I've been making the spaghetti and. Gary of the Amendum show, they're making his spaghetti, so it is old, and I'm like, well, what is the deal? Is he some terrible aggravant that is already here and not even on the internet at all, and he's just teasing me? Sometimes I think so. I think he is just, I don't know, it's all my personal brain show out here. And he already knew that I was making the spaghetti, so he said the spaghetti on his show. So there it goes. Well, it goes into having in common and why. And why. And yes, I'm painting dark and then the light on top of the dark. And he was also doing this. So it is easy to start racking up sames. We're having sames, you know, similars. And yeah, there is something there that wants to find, what do you call it when the persons, they have to wear the pink outfits, the man wears the pink and the woman wears the pink, and then they walk into the store and they're wearing the pink outfit day, and then the other day they have the orange or the yellow, and those ones are weird when they really get into, let's share everything. But no, the quantum actual is just binging it really loud, and perhaps so I am sending out, it was a major change in my life to start eating the spaghetti, because I'm not really a spaghetti eater so much. And so that was my major being out I was sending. So there is a strength there. There is a strength just by the newness of the factor. The newness of the factor. Now, I'm not telling you now. I did not eating a spaghetti today, but I'm not going to tell you the change, and I'll verify if somebody's out there. They might, yes, they're already in annoyance of what it is, just my mind communication to and through the machine. Well, why am such a heavy metal head to it? I don't know. It seems to talk with me, and I talk back to it, and it's, I'm not sure. I'm not really a great controller of it, that's for sure, but, it does seem to be an input, acknowledgement of my own particular thoughts, that it is already knowing it. It is already knowing and available to listen and even taunt me with some. So it is alive in a way, it is feel alive, yes, the machine does start to feel as alive. After a while it starts to feel like a mirror. Really bad mirror, bad, but then look at all the times in the self, at the meanness to the self, you know, just the vanities to it. Oh my gosh, my face, my hair, my... Everything, it's just like, And so we fight this, and we fight this, and we fight this, and we fight this. No, I'm really, really not having that bad of a day. It's not that bad. It's not that aggressive. And yet, sometimes I'm getting the turn. I'm getting the turn opposite. You know, the turn opposite is what? Oh, she really doesn't like this. Well, so we'll give it to her, won't we? She really doesn't like this, so we will give it to her. Seems as longer as my life has gone on, it is becoming that show. I was going to talk a little of the solitary, but it is a pushy computer even with that. It has that solitary game on it with every issue of this of these operating system. Solitary itself is not actually the problem. After a while it becomes, oh my gosh, I'm not sure I can live other way. Now, and there's others, you know, it's like, what do you want, you know, after a while? What do you actually want from me? They start to feel like bloodsuckers and leeches. Try to harvest my brain or something. There is a time in the future, and they are the eye thieves. And you look at them with your eyes open, and they are able to actually go from transfer to transfer. This is, perhaps it is an alien form, I'm not sure how this is working, some metal transference form. But it is able to go in from one part of the eye mechanism of one person and then go into the eye mechanism of another. And when it reaches this eye mechanism of the other, it does end up in the person's dream realm, I will say it, the dream realm, in their imagination realm, quite heavy. And they become attempters of thought takers. So it's like a mean metal bouncer. I don't like to look at the persons anymore, eye to eye. I don't even know if they are the same person that they are expressed there in physical body form, or merely a metal that has bounced from another, from a prior personage. Heavy metal bouncers. Oh my gosh, this is a beautiful, beautiful artist I saw out there. I guess name is a Whitten? Mark Whitten, and he is making exactation in real exact of the animals. Wow, incredible, incredible. Exact replica. He starts on the white, he has the white, and then he puts the black silhouette of the animal, and then he dives in there from that moment. It is interesting, I've never seen that version of it, but yeah, the black silhouette. But yeah, these metal eye bouncers, trying to live as you, essentially. They're trying to live through you and live as you. It's almost as if they are... what do you call this, like an energy information theft. So we're calling them mind thought thieves. When your mind is essentially grabbed at, and everything that you are just walking around in your day, they're claiming as their own particular material, and they will leave you eventually and go to another. If my other is merely here also on this camera, then it's another way out. Yeah, so mind thought thieves eye to eye. And also that's funny when we think of the song, hush hush eye to eye, blah blah blah. Getting tired of it, I'm not sure who the heck you are any longer. Yeah, mind thought thieves. They even want to go with you in the kitchen for a moment. What are you doing in your kitchen? We just want to inspect it, want to inspect the kitchen. Becomes a little hyped up, this world next. I know, everybody wants to know this musical painting. Tell us the musical paintings. We want to know how these are done. They're an annoyance. They're an annoyance, actual creation, specifically to... Because the original hybrids were really just obnoxious sounds driven. Obnoxious sounds, very low wavelength, similar to a swarm, similar to obnoxious insects. Later on, the technology becomes the voice. Technology is not simply this type of So originally the music painting was made for this to stop them, because they are such an interruptant, that you have to have something on constant. And for some reason, certain sounds drive them away. It is originally their intake. It's about the intake of the frequencies in the room, and changes to. So when you move one thing, one item in the room, the sound from the painting also alters. It's listening. It has listening devices within, so it hears through mini fiber optics there. And then it is in the replay, all of the different fractionalities, I'll say, of the different, this one over here, I know it is numerations in the future. It's what we're looking at. 457 over there, and then here we have a 792, and so, and then it is a harmonizing. It's a harmonizing event. But the painting itself, the actual painting itself, is truly the fiber optic and how it is relayed around with the sound in all of the different colors. So it actually is a painting, but it's more of a musical instrument also. So we have the, what is this, this over here is a listener. The 779 is specifically listening to a certain area in the room. And it's when that area changes, it goes to 779 down to 521. And so you have the 521, and still over here there's 479. And so it has that like a blend that it's making with it, that changes the tune, the reference of the original tune. So that is a music painting in the future there. So I don't know. So the I have a sadness there for the vanadium glass group there, whole entire populace that was demanding it for quite a heavy moment, and then now in the not able to deliver the message and ask and a request of. Sometimes I don't know what the agenda is in any of these metals that have been roaming in our bodies from the very beginning of our birth. You know, what they've been out here millions of years. And you put the metals together a specific way, we're saying, oh, this is us in our time now. This is this human species putting these metals together. That is boisterous of us, isn't it, to always claim it as us. Even this thing with the nuclear now, the heavy build of the nuclear, it's just so possible that this is an agenda other. I've never seen such a build of the nuclear. This is ridiculous. It is an insanity. It is an insanity. Even the shape of this last one, I'll go into the Fukushima shape of it. And it is a hidden totem. It is the hidden totem man, the hidden totem of the man. All over, they're having this particular design. They're all happy with this man erectus. So there he is in his blatant erection, in the just taunting Mother Nature, isn't it? It's so large, this is a taunt to Mother Nature. So, well, Mother Nature, are you going to come and attack it, you know? Or Mother Nature, are you going to just bring tsunami? Mother Nature, do you really, really, really want to be this phallic? When you think of the Easter Island heads there, Easter Island head frames, oh my gosh. These persons have an ego going, don't they? I just had to say that at the very beginning. It's all we have to see. See the heads of the Easter Island there. They've got an ego so big, watch out. I don't think it's ever going to go away. So now we are here, and what is this? Don't mess with Texas size. Yeah, a little too much, so. What is what does Mother Nature do? She has earthquake there, trying to get to it, you know, and so it just becomes some sick artist's agenda that he can play with. There's Mother Nature, she's desperate for it. Because my gosh, what is there in the man state any longer? She doesn't have a man any longer. She's just a woman there, lonely woman who needs her her dildo. So there she is and represents earthquakes and tsunami. Moving Mother Nature around, she's getting hungry for just, my gosh. You're not gonna kill her sex. You can say her sex could kill the world. Blame it on her. Her want for sex. It's kind of an attractive self, you know, you're looking at the tops of the mountains, high. They're the most dangerous. Oh my gosh, it's a hype, huh? It's a hype to think Mother Nature is getting all of that. And there it is, and just in, and there, you think of the I will say they're funny, the, oh, are they? They're in their penuries. Their penuries of place. But they are the Christian rites. And what are they doing? They're walking by this building with this massive penis inside. Oh my gosh. One would think we could just maybe not need so much energy just from that, you know, just, we just don't need this electricity so much. Sometimes persons who are abusive and we cannot stop them, even in the same house. Why do we have these types of persons? Who have to wash their clothes every day? Who go OCD extra? Just last week, I left the oven on by accident, all in the day, for I don't know, 6 or 7 hours, and I, oh my gosh, I'm heart stricken. It brings the tears. How could I have done it? How could I have left it on? Yeah, when you're a mother or a person you're living with that has the OCD and has to electrify everything again and again, heat the water, again and again, take the bath, again and again, what are we doing again and again? Where every day we have to shower, every day we have to bathe, every day we have to reheat the waters extra. I mean, how dirty and filthy are you, my God? Every day you have to wash the clothes. Yeah, so I have like a drastic bill because they take the one bill from a year ago. And can't stop a person who's busy in this action. Nobody can. So yeah, I guess so. I need it readjusted. Somebody has to call it. I guess I'm 2,000 away or something. They call them 2,000 away from the real bill number. But yeah, I'm thinking also the future. We have to make these. We have to have beepers on these stoves. That you can have in another room that you spend much of your time in, and at least, and it will say it's on, it's off. Just a carry beeper. It has to be included with all of these stoves. I can't stand this any longer. Did I leave it on? Did I leave it on? So I was also, I didn't make that. I made this website of the I don't know, I don't really want to talk of it, yeah. I'll leave that for another video. Oh gosh, this is a monotonous painting. It all has too many things at once.